Hi there, this is Megan from Home Science Tools. And today I'm going to walk you through how to use the Erycard blood typing kit. This is a super fun hands-on science kit that allows you to test your blood type from home. You can do this with your kids as a science activity, or just do it for fun with some of your friends. Inside this Erycard blood typing kit, you will find one instruction manual, a lancet to prick your finger, an Erycard device inside this packet here, a small bottle of buffer solution, 4 blood collection sticks, and 1 alcohol wipe pad. Let's go ahead and open up the Erycard. And it looks something like this. All right, let's dive into the step-by-step process of how to use the Erycard. I have removed the Erycard from the original packet here. You can see that there are instructions as well as a key to kind of tell you how to read it at the very end. This is on the back of that Erycard device packet here. So I will leave that there. We have all of the supplies ready. We have the Erycard, we have our buffer solution, we have our lancet alcohol prep pad, and we have our blood collection sticks here. So the very first step here is to open your alcohol prep pad. And you're going to decide which finger you want to prick. So I'm going to choose a finger on my non-dominant hand so that I can use my right dominant hand for much of the process. So I will go ahead and do my ring finger here, getting it nice and clean with the alcohol swab. The next step is just to remove the protective cap on the thin end of the lancet. So it's not this end here, it's this little thin end. You actually twist and pull, and the lancet is now ready to use. Place it onto the finger that you just cleaned with alcohol swab, and you're gonna press with your thumb until you feel a prick. Set your lancet aside, and you can see that blood is starting to pool. You take your first sample stick, collect a droplet of blood, and stick it in A for about 2 to 3 seconds. We're gonna repeat that. I'll get another sample. I'm using gravity to help me out here, to keep that blood dripping. And we are putting this blood into the row that's labeled S. We're not gonna put any blood into the R row at the bottom. Get my third drop here. Remember to use a different stick for every single sample and drop. I have it in D now. And the very last one in row S is our control, which is important. It's just gonna allow us to know if we did the test properly. So make sure you get some blood in that control well. All right. I feel like I could have a little more there. I'll go ahead and add a little more into the pad. Great, so I kept it in order A, B, D, and control. If you need to add any more blood, it looks like D almost could use a little additional blood. So I'm just gonna add a little bit in there, using the same collection stick that I used before. You can take your alcohol prep pad and just kind of clean off your finger. It will begin to clot, so, and the bleeding will stop. So the next step is just to let the blood sit in the wells, remembering this is only in row S. We're not doing anything with row R yet. Row S, let it sit for 45 to 60 seconds. So we're gonna just let that sit for just a moment so that the pads in all 4 of these can really absorb the blood samples. You can get your buffer solution ready because the next step we're gonna add 2 drops of buffer solution in the R row. So the one right below that we have not touched yet. We've let that sit for just a bit here and we're gonna add 2 drops into each R well. Oh wait, just a couple more seconds. All right, adding 2 drops to each. All right, now we just get to watch and see what happens over the next 3 minutes. Basically, what is gonna happen is this will start to change. The test will change and certain wells will stay red or they will completely become clear. You can see that B is losing all of its color. And in just a couple minutes, I'm gonna be able to tell exactly what blood type I have using this card here. I can read what my results are. So we'll give that just a couple minutes and watch what happens. It looks like the control has turned clear as well. Now, it is really important that the control turns clear. This is how we tell that the test is valid. Because it is turning clear, I can trust that the rest of my result is accurate. It looks like my results are ready. So we have, my A well has stayed red. The B has completely cleared and become colorless. D has stayed red as well, although I didn't get quite enough blood in it, maybe it's, but you can tell that it's not colorless. And the control is colorless, meaning that this is a valid test, that it worked properly, and we can trust the results. So if you look at this card here, if we're reading and trying to interpret my results, you see that the first one there, A and D have remained red, and the B and control have become clear, so I have A positive blood. Now, I knew ahead of time that I did have A positive blood, and I'm really confident that this result is accurate. For all of the other blood types, you can see what the wells would look like, which ones would remain red, which ones would become colorless. Are you ready to find out your blood type? Visit homesciencetools.com to find this blood typing kit and more.